It smells like gamma-ray cinnabase in her thigh distilling. Is the set ready?
I think so. I know several missed calls, so I think they probably went ahead with the list that you left them.
All this has happened before, and it will happen again.
I was thinking of getting a pet seagull, but do you think that's like the wrong kind of gang? What is going on here?
Sounds good to be good to go.
Are you Bryan Huynh?
I'm he. Who are you?
Arthur. Arthur St. Croix. I'm the creative director.
I don't care. What are you doing in my apartment? Explain this to me, Alicia.
The higher-ups from JD and Cain sent me to help you. Do you want it or not?
When JD and Cain start losing confidence in some of their artists, they send me. Arthur St. Croix. I guess I'm kind of like an insurance or something. I mean, this guy Bryan or whatever just can't seem to get his act together without pissing off some pretty important people. I just want my paycheck.
Help me? This place looks like it was decorated by a 10th grade emo after a My Chemical Romance binge.
I don't care how it looks. Do whatever, but make it scary and creepy. Loves ya, JK. You are ugly and your mother sucks cocks in hell. Rafflecopter. LMAO. Thanks. Bryan. XOXOXO. These are the words you wrote on this notepad. Hey, could you set that up there, buddy?
No, buddy. Can you set it over there? Alicia, come on, we have to get this mess organized.
Listen, I think we got off on the wrong foot. I know it's not cool having someone come in and—
Ugh. Stop. Just stop. Admit that you're wrong and leave.
Fine. Will that make you feel better?
No, but it'll make you feel like shit, so I don't really care. Okay? Okay, now get off my set before I cut a bitch.
I've seen him do that.
Fine. Okay, whatever, man. Do what you want.
Can we start, like, shooting now?
Shut up! Why are you still here?
I'm obligated to stay till the shoot's done. Unless you want me to go, then you'll have to explain to JD and Cain that you disobeyed their orders. Good luck.
Bryan, please, we have an hour until deadline.
Fine. Whatever. You, Anthony.
Arthur.
Finish this, unless you're too busy being ugly.
Thought you said it looked like shit.
It does, but instead of looking like cold, wet diarrhea, how about we make it a nice, firm stool? Okay? Good. Great. You, hair and makeup, now. Stylist!
You gonna go run after him? Imagine if this was being filmed. What a dump.
Bryan's never had to deal with anyone like Arthur before. There's something odd about him. I've heard of JD and Cain using creative directors to monitor their photographers, and frankly, it's a bit intimidating. You know, last time Bryan put any sort of trust in someone, he... Well, I don't think I'm allowed to talk about it.
I feel like it needs a little red.
This is terrible. Make her look beat up. She needs a visit to the doctor, and that doctor's name is Chris Brown. By the way, you are a midget.
Kate Moss is 5'6".
Bitch, you ain't Kate Moss.
What do you seriously think? Too much?
Yeah. No.
Yeah.
I don't know.
You act like no one's ever asked for your real opinion before.
You're here for one reason and one reason only. To be the best. They're scared of you. All of them are scared of you. You know why? Because no one is this fucking hot. No one deserves to be this fucking hot.
Two paces behind.
All right, everybody, let's get ready. Not bad, eh?
Four ahead a row. It's time. Let's get started.
Everyone quiet on set, please.
What drives you, Bryan?
I look around and I see all these little girls and dandelion vomit floral and parachute pants and the guys, don't even get me started. What's in for them is looking like gay hipster spiders with their fucking denim jackets and little click-clacky brown shoes. It's like, calm down, faggotrons. But who knows? Tomorrow they could be wearing something entirely different. Models stick around long enough for you to vaguely remember their face, only to become obsolete by age 19. In fashion. Fashion's oddly wonderful. It's exciting to be on the cutting edge to see the change, and you can only try to adapt when something new arrives and ponder on what is permanent and what's short-lived. I'll never stop. This is my life, and it's my job as a fashion photographer to capture that change. It's Bryan's world. You just don't know it yet. Well, that went well considering time scheduling, crew, how I have to deal with
happy for your shoot, but listen, I think we need to spend some more quality time together. So, I booked us for a sculpture class next week. It's gonna be so fun. You get to use clay. Wow.
Okay. Pick up some cat food for those crazy felines. If I don't, they'll start eating themselves. Ugh, my 8 o'clock sharp. Bye, schnookums. Mwah.
Thanks for the help today.
What a fucking nightmare.
JD and Cain in the magazine will be pleased, though. You really did it.
Look at that map.
So, what are we gonna do now?
Why do you always ask such stupid questions?